Smallpox is the most formidable and devastating disease in human history that has caused more death and suffering than any other human infectious disease.
You had about a 1 in 3 chance of catching it during your lifetime. Even if you survived, you weren't that lucky because you could be badly scarred. It killed the kings, queens, princes, princesses, tsars. Queen Mary I of England, her husband William II, Queen Mary II of England, Louis I of Spain, Louis XV of France, Chinese emperors. Pocahontas allegedly died of smallpox.
The Europeans brought it to the Americas with them.
When you look at what happened to Native Americans, smallpox was far more powerful than the US Army. Smallpox just decimated them. George Washington had smallpox before he became president. Abraham Lincoln developed smallpox while president, and in fact, he was in his early symptoms when he gave the Gettysburg Address.
Variola virus is the virus that causes smallpox disease.
It's certainly one of the largest of the viruses we have. We can actually see it under a plain microscope.
Pox viruses have larger genomes. The genome, for example, HIV is only about 10 genes. Ebola is 7 genes. Smallpox is a couple of 100 genes.
The virus is a dumbbell wrapped with 2 membranes and then decorated with all these tubules sticking out of it like a porcupine.
Smallpox can only make humans sick. A lot of viruses that infect us can also infect certain other species. But with smallpox, we are its only host.
It's totally inert. It's just a capsule with 2 strands of DNA in it that can do nothing until they get into a cell. And then they commandeer that cell, and they make that cell produce more of them.
Smallpox can spread through very, very tiny, moist droplets that come out of the back of a person's mouth when they cough or speak. If you should inhale one of these droplets, that's enough to trigger an infection, which could easily be fatal.
Thank you.